In this video, we're going to build a full-stack application using Memex's MCP capabilities. We're going to connect to Neon for the backend database, and we're going to host it on Netlify. But before we get into the full-stack application, I'm going to show you some simple MCP capabilities, such as connecting to Hacker News, so you can use Memex both as kind of a Claude desktop replacement. And you're going to see how it can go from Claude Desktop to a cursor replacement all in one with MCP. Thank you so much to Memex for sponsoring this video. Click the link in the description to download Memex and build alongside me. Let's jump into it. So you need to make sure you're on the latest version of Memex. And then we're going to go to the gear on the bottom left. You just have to select MCP. And then there's three options here. There's a server directory where you can just install directly from Memex. And you can also add custom servers and add any MCP server that you want. To quickly test this out and show you the power of MCP, I'm going to go down to Hacker News, the Hacker News MCP, which allows Memex to get the top stories on Hacker News and summarize discussion threads. Let's install that. So it just takes a second to install. And then if we go to configured servers on the top, we can see the Hacker News is installed and it is currently turned on. You can turn it off and turn it on. And then these are the tools that Memex is going to have the ability to use. The way that MCP works is the AI is going to use any of these tools that it deems necessary based on the conversation that you're having. So let's test this out. Let's start a chat. And instead of building something using code the way that we have used Memex in the past, we're going to use it almost like a marketer would use Claude Desktop to ask the AI to just answer questions for us. So let's say, what are the top three stories on Hacker News right now? And we'll send this off. Here we can see MCP was used, get stories, and it got the three top stories on Hacker News right now. We can check this. And here we can see the top story, why SSL was renamed to TLS in the late 90s. And on my feed, it's number 5 right now, but it does have 357 points. So I think it's doing it by points instead of by ranking, because there is some sort of algorithm. But it did work, which is really cool. We got an actual story that is on the front page of Hacker News. And these as well are on the front page of Hacker News. But let's go back to MCP and let's go to the server directory. And I want to show you what else is possible using the Memex MCP feature. So we're going to go down to Netlify, and I want to install Netlify, and it's going to give us setup requirements and tell us how to set this up, which is also really nice. Something that's hard about MCP a lot of the time, it requires you to be technical to understand how to set it up. I really love how Memex has made this easy for a non-technical person to just follow instructions and get it set up. So it's telling me I need to create a personal access token for my Netlify account. So I'm going to go to this link and do that. And then we'll click next. And I just have to enter my access token. So I'm going to pause the video and do that and then hit complete. And then just go down and click install server. So now my Netlify server is installing. And then what this is going to allow us to do, if we go to configured servers and we click and see the tools. So this is going to allow us to actually deploy what we're building on Memex to the internet so anyone can access it instead of just building on our local machine. So adding these MCPs just gives Memex all of these additional capabilities. And I want to test this out now. So let's go back. Let's go to the homepage. And why don't we just quickly build a landing page? Let's go to the create a landing page template here in Memex. We did a whole video previously on using Memex templates, so I highly recommend going to our channel and checking out that video if you're interested. But we're going to go and ask it to build us a landing page. Let's say a simple portfolio landing page for a web designer. Make it really sleek and Apple-like design. So we're going to do the build. And we can just go ahead and send off this prompt. So it's going to create the project. And by using the template, it's going to have all of this additional, basically prompt information that's going to help make sure that we're going to get a high quality template. So you can see based on the project rules, which is with the template, it's going to install the correct dependencies. It's going to kind of has in the prompt to make it a production worthy design. use specific components and icons, use unsplash images where appropriate. The sleek and Apple-like design was something I wrote, and then run the project in the background. So let me pause the video while it creates this, and then I'll let you know what it looks like when it's done. And here we are with our first version of the landing page that it created. So we can see it made a really nice, actually, portfolio website. I really like it. And of course, we could edit it more. It just created like a fake person and used an image from Unsplash. But all of that, we could just ask Memex to update for ourselves if we wanted to. But what I really want to show you in this video is how to use the Netlify MCP to go from localhost. So you can see at the top bar, this is localhost. What that means is we are running this on our local computer. No one else could access this. Now, if I go to the bottom and let's ask to please use Netlify to deploy this to the internet. And let's see now if Memex is able to use our Netlify MCP server to actually deploy our code so anyone can access it. Okay, a quick tip. I saw that Memex was going to bypass the MCP and start to install Netlify on our command line and do it basically through the command line, which is another way to do this, but I want to make sure it uses the MCP. So something that you should keep in mind, this is something I've noticed with Memex, with other tools that you're using MCP with. You want to clarify when you want the AI to use the MCP sometimes, because it can, if it knows another way to do it, it might do that. So I'm going to say using Netlify MCP to deploy this to the internet. And now let's send the message and let's see if this changes the behavior of the AI. And there we go. I can already see it's working. It says, looking at the available functions, I can see the Netlify related functions. So when you include MCP in your prompt, it's going to make sure that the AI basically reviews all of the capabilities that it has before kind of doing it a different way. So this is great. And it is going to now create a new project with the name. Let me just pause the video while it finishes it up. Here's what Memex has given us. We have a live site URL, so it has deployed this through Netlify. And there's also some just cool information, like how long it took to deploy, how many files were uploaded. So let's click on it here. And here we go. This is an actual URL that anyone can access. It's hosted on my Netlify account. And I can see it all is working. So pretty amazing that was able to be created all through Memex and through the MCP. This is kind of like Claude Desktop, which is basically just the Claude chat, which can use MCP, combined with Cursor, which has the coding ability and the ability to access your terminal and access your computer, but then publish through MCP. So it's kind of a combination between the ease of use of Claude Desktop, but then the capabilities of Cursor at the same time. We're now going to take all this to the next level by adding Neon to our MCP servers. And what this is going to do is allow us to add a Neon Postgres database, which is basically going to allow us to build full stack applications using Memex. So we're going to have the backend being Neon, which is going to be our database. You're going to see how easy this is to do. And then we're going to be able to publish it using Netlify. So we're going to have all of it combined together, and you're going to see how powerful MCP can be with Memex. So let's just go ahead and click install here. And just like when we were installing Netlify, it's going to give us some instructions. It uses OAuth authentication. So it's going to open your browser, or you can authorize it in your Neon account. We're going to need a Neon account first. So just go to this URL and make sure you have an account if you don't already. So we'll just go ahead and complete that and then click install server. And here we can see it popped up. I just have to approve. This is going to authorize to connect Neon to our Memex account. And then here I can see it was connected. We go back to configured servers and Neon is connected. So this is just really great that we have this server directory. I'm sure that Memex is going to continue adding more MCP servers to the directory to just make it really easy to add. But then, of course, you can add any server using the custom server settings. It's just a little bit more complicated. It's really not too hard to do, but the server directory makes it a lot easier. And then Neon is giving us all sorts of tools to allow us to build our database into our project. So what I want to do now is build on to this project here. So what I want to do is let me write a prompt and then I'll come back in a second. The prompt is I want to add a backend Neon database using MCP. And I also want to have an admin page where I can make changes to my site, such as the key images and projects for the portfolio, which will update the Neon database. Use the Neon MCP to build this out. So I'm going to send this away. Before I let it build out the whole thing, I do want to show you, this is really cool, is that it just started thinking about how it was going to do this. And it realized first it needs to use the MCP to create a project in a database. So it's going to connect to my account, see the projects, and it is going to now create a new project so we can have a dedicated database here. It created it, and now it is creating the tables for that project. So it's creating tables for projects, services, personal information, potentially blog posts or testimonials. So it's running SQL now to create these tables in the database. And we can see now it's inserting initial data to populate the database. So it's doing all of these things completely on its own. Again, I'll pause the video while it goes through all this, but I just wanted to show you that right off the bat to show you kind of what MCP is able to do. It thought through every step. It went from creating the database utility files, environment variables, API routes, all of this technical things that most people don't want to have to deal with. So Memex takes care of it. And all you have to do was just send that initial prompt of like what you wanted it to do. And it went through the entire thing. It looks like it's doing a couple more things, so I'm going to let it finish before testing it out. So after some debugging that Memex did all on its own, I didn't have to interfere at all, the deployment is successful to Netlify. So it created the Neon database, it built out the admin page, it made it so that we can make changes on the admin page to update the live website, and it's all deployed on Netlify so that anyone on the internet can access it. So let me just show you what happened here, which is pretty cool. So it saw that it was running into issues with deployment. Right here, we can see the deployment failed, and then it realized what the likely issue was, and then it had to set up environment variables in Netlify. So it did all this, then it realized it's still failing, and it needed to simplify the approach and make some changes and create the API's Netlify functions. So it did all of this, and then we can see it did work. So we have two URLs right now, the main portfolio and the admin interface. So let me pull those in. So here is the main URL, and then here's the admin interface. So here we can see the projects that are on the page, and then here are those projects that correspond, minimal e-commerce. We have the services, which if we go down to services, here we can see web design, mobile, brand development. Those are all here. And then under the profile, just the basic information. So let's say I want to just change a little bit of information here. So let me just make this a little bit bigger. Let's edit the profile. So let's click edit profile. Let's change the bio to I'm the founder of No Code MBA. And what I want to do is just save that. I'll start with just that. So I'm going to click save. I'm the founder of No Code MBA is now here. Let me refresh the page. And now this updated here on the live site, which is really, really cool that this all worked. And of course, we could make even more changes. If at any point you try to make a change and it doesn't work, we would just go back to Memex, say, hey, I tried to do this, but it didn't work. So there might be a little bit of debugging that you'd have to do. But the fact that Memex was able to do this with MCP is really, really impressive. So we were able, through Memex MCP connecting to Neon and Netlify, to have a full stack application built with the backend database through Neon and then publishing it and hosting it on Netlify. I hope you enjoyed this video and you learned how powerful Memex and MCP combined together can be. You can think about it as combining Claude Desktop with Cursor together. Be sure to subscribe to our channel to get more free content like this. Click the link in the description and build with Memex MCP yourself. Leave a comment below if you have any questions or if there's anything about Memex you want us to cover in the future. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.